Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Kai checking in with another video. And today, we got some more Philly Reddit, y'all. This right here is YBC versus the City Part 1. It's Philly Reddit. It's gonna get into it.
In 2010, a new genre of rap and probably its most destructive subgenre of the culture, drill, was started in Chicago. Rappers like Lil Durk, Lil Reese, Chief Keef, King Von, and others made a career off of rapping about specific murders or drills that happen in their gangs. Street dudes took that and ran with it, as people who don't rap or have no business rapping saw YouTube and streaming as a way to make money, if they had no talent. Fans seem to care more about what you did in the streets than your rap skills. Punchlines and metaphors come second to going fed and talking about your street beef.
Facts. That's a fact. You got some ones that's goaded, though, that could, you know, throw punchlines and metaphors in there and then, like, go super goaded. Like, you got some motherfuckers like a Herb, Bibby ain't really do no, like, real, like, drill rap. You got motherfuckers like L.A. Capone who did that shit. Like, you got some motherfuckers that was just goaded with that shit that could throw some punchlines and metaphors in there and still be disrespectful.
Anything for clout and views. The more federal you go, the more attention you get. In Philadelphia, in 2018, there were 353 lives lost to violence. During the pandemic of 2020, that number skyrocketed to 499.
That niggas are supposed to be in the house. God damn.
During that year, a lot of money was floating around due to PUA, PPP loans. Some of that money was used to buy guns.
A lot of that money was used to buy guns.
Called switches also started to come into play around this time, which made drills that much more dangerous and reckless. Now with the tap of the trigger, you could spray a whole block up in 5 seconds. That brings us to our main topic today. A group called YBC and the crazy last year and a half they've had. As I said earlier, talent is not the biggest factor to drill rappers and their fans. King Von was successful off the fact that he killed multiple people and rapped about it. Not only that, but he saw major success. Young bulls are emulating this and trying to copy this formula. What sets YBC apart, however, is how disrespectful they are to their dead ops and how quickly they crashed out.
Rizzy to the face, bitch, I can't throw him in rotation. He was a foot soldier, but he ain't make his destination. Damn. Ain't nothing to view, they took his face, he need cremation. Damn. If they grab me for this song, Rizzy to the face, bitch, I can't throw him in rotation. He was a foot soldier, but he ain't make his destination. Damn. Ain't nothing to view, they took his face, he need cremation. Damn. If they grab me for this song, I'ma stand tall in the station. A5, he not out there. I know that. And Brody Wallet, he be tweaking, got bees like a hot
smoke, buddy. I smoke last night with the bet. I get up close and put his ass to sleep like with the bet. Mr. Trolley, all that trolling that you doing, won't get you left. And you ain't Undertaker, you ain't coming back from this death.
I'll be home real soon, man.
Mo! This nigga is. What the fuck? Bruh. I'm not from Philly, so it's my first time hearing all this. This nigga just said, what?
Smoke last night with the bet. I get up close and put his ass to sleep like with the bet. Mr. Trolley, all that trolling that you doing, won't get you left. And you ain't Undertaker, you ain't coming back from this death.
Nah, he right. Whoever the robot nigga is.
They got the numbers.
Hey, whoever this robot nigga is, he right, man. This nigga, these niggas is just they. They mouth so uncontrollable, like, what the fuck?
No, man. They be back real soon.
YBC wasn't really heard of by most of Philly until around 2018. J100 has been dropping music for years, but no mention of YBC or YFA until about 2017 or 2018. They come from the bottom of West Philly for the most part and are probably most infamous for their disrespectful lyrics. J100 started as a trap rapper, talking mostly about the everyday struggles of living in the hood.
I got a trade from the muscle, niggas don't know what it is. Stuck in the struggle, put it together like puzzles. Think about copping the muscle. This little car on the beat, don't be in Miami, but we get the heat. Carry the pistol, I'm in the target. All of my cousin, I lost it. All of my cousin, I lost it. Not taking the opposite serious. We laughing, we build like a horse. Bobby, see, no, I won't change up. And my been it through, see you what you gon' do, and they gon' shoot. Hey, you ran just McCobe again. Pistol tucked up in my trench coat, it's getting cold again.
Jay's music was good, but things weren't popping like he wanted with the music. YBC are mostly between the ages of 16 and 23. So back in 2017, these are really young guys. Their beefs would start in school, fights and small scuffles between them and others from around West Philly made them start to click up. In 2019, Josh died and they named the area Josh World for their fallen member.
On Wednesday, May 29th, 2019, Joshua David Munson was along the 4200 block of Wyalusing Avenue in Philadelphia's Parkside section. At 1:40 p.m., police were called to the area for a person with a gun.
Upon arrival, police observed the victim, who was later ID'd as Joshua Munson. He was suffering from multiple gunshot wounds and was taken to Presbyterian Hospital, where he was listed in critical condition.
Unfortunately, the 18-year-old died from his injuries on May 31st.
As I said a minute ago, they started to call themselves YBC or Young Bag Chasers because at the time that's most of what they were doing was chasing a bag. The most recognizable people from YBC are J100, YBC Duel aka Mr. Disrespectful, Eam Stacks, Baby Ka, Reek 1200, and many others that put in work behind the scenes. As people in the camp started to die like Josh and Skeel, the young bulls in the group started to turn up. YBC currently has beef with about 6 or 7 different blocks in West Philly, and to try and get into all of it is almost impossible. So to stay focused, we will talk about a few different incidents here, as this is the first of 3 parts. Jaquan Williams was shot in Philadelphia on Saturday, January 16, 2021.
This is what it's the shit that I be saying, bro. This, hey, kids, even adults. Yo. Be aware of your surroundings. I'm not even talking about, just be aware. It's a camera on every corner. It's a camera on every door. This is not the 80s anymore. It's not the 90s anymore. It's not the early 2000s anymore. We live in a technology era. Nigga don't gotta snitch on y'all no more. The camera gonna catch you. Y'all dumb motherfuckers keep thinking, oh, that camera don't work. Bitch, the camera don't work. You don't know that shit, nigga. You don't. How the fuck would you know that? How would you know? I hear so many conversations with, like, so many conversations, they're like, yeah, that camera don't work, bro. How the fuck would you know? It don't work until you get caught on that shit. Then all of a sudden it's, oh, nigga snitching on, woo, woo. Like, no, nigga. Use your fucking head. Come on, man. Look, we watching this shit play out. Like, we watching all this shit on camera. All this shit is literally on camera. Like, we watch 4 different angles. Camera. Like, it's cameras on all these houses, bro. Like, clear ass camera right here. These, hey, do y'all not understand that these niggas got facial recognition? It's a thing called facial recognition. your shit could be like this. Nigga, damn Nick, the feds, the police, cause, oh man, we know who that is. The mark on his face, the woo woo. They don't need nothing but that much to check you out, bruh. Like, just be smarter with what y'all doing, bruh.
At 4:06 p.m., Philadelphia police officers responded to the 4,000 block of Cambridge Street and found Jaquan lying in the street. He was suffering from a gunshot wound. Police placed Jaquan in their patrol vehicle and transported him to Penn Presbyterian Medical Center. Despite efforts by the hospital's staff to save his life, Jaquan died on Sunday, January 17, 2021. Quani, or Quani Raw, was from Peach Street, in West Philly. But he claimed DeMont, who are clicked up with 39th Street. That will be relevant later in the story. I mentioned earlier that YBC was most known for being very disrespectful towards their ops dead homies. It doesn't matter if they're innocent, the intended target, or people that are guilty by association. Collateral damage be damned. YBC are the definition of wreck chasers. They don't care who they hit as long as they are from your side. That's the most dangerous part of the new generation of street bulls. The indiscriminate violence is out of pocket. Then bragging and rapping about it is even worse.
We got different glocks for all these different ops claiming this beef. He slipped in that car, he hopped off fast, I met here in the corner. We gon' sell like 900 on the 9, that's what it took, we caught him. We get over, know they mad, cause what's your name, got put to bed. 12 to the race, they had these thuggets out of crib, he still
a- Nah, even when you break it down, like, yeah, that's kind of ass backwards. Like, sometimes you got a random, you got a motherfucker that can't control where he from, like. Like, a lot, that's damn near bullying at that point. Like, you getting up on a nigga who you know ain't with the shit. Like, all right, you know this nigga, he just live over there kind of thing. That's damn near bullying. Like, he ain't gonna do nothing to you. He ain't trying to do nothing to you. He ain't in no beef. He just live there. He ain't in no pics. He a random kid. He a good kid. Sometimes you got a good kid, and they just get caught up in shit just from being in that area. We see that shit all the time. Those type stories, I don't like those type shit, cause that shit y'all like lame.
Last time I been through the grand trade, they was tripping and falling. I thought we had another pack. Sure, what was they could get their favorite athlete back? I was snipe smoking snipe, I rolling buddy.
This nigga is, hey. His name is his name, bro. This nigga said they wish they could get their best athlete back. I remember doing a Philly Reddit. They said the dude, one of the dudes that died, he was a star athlete of the basketball team. And this nigga is just, this nigga's crazy, man.
Last time I been through the grand trade, they was tripping and falling. I thought we had another pack. Sure, what was they could get their favorite athlete back? I was snipe smoking snipe, got rolling buddy all the same. Just smoking four right now. He caught that switch, he to the brain. Snipe got caught up at the light. K3 just had it full of flame. Had he tried to do graveyard, so bro just hit him with the flame. That's him, Millie, really big.
Bruh, we did the video on this. They did the motherfucking Timmy Turner Philly Opern sample. Bruh, these niggas is crazy.
All the strands up, they all hit them 4-4. Can't accept the fact they main event them 4-9. Sick as truly got hit in the shit. And now I know what's up with us, cause bro got added to the list.
Quani was just 15 when he was killed, but it doesn't matter your age. If they think you're an opponent, they believe you're fair game. No arrests have been made in this case so far. Moving on from Quani, we have another of the most dissed people YBC has talked about, and that's Sid or Big 3-9. From 39th and Reno, Sid was a carrier for his team. He was also one of YBC's most wanted. Rodney Hargrove, 20, of Philadelphia, was killed about 47 minutes after being freed on bail at 1 a.m. near the front gates of CFCF on State Road in the early morning hours of March 18, 2021. Hargrove, who had been held on theft and related charges since March 11th, was driven to a bus stop.
This remind me of the little joint from Chicago. Who the fuck was that? I forgot Shorty's name. He was super disrespectful too. And I'm talking about he got killed soon as he got out the jail. Like, that shit is crazy. Like,
by corrections officers after his release. There, a dark-colored vehicle began pursuing him and he ran back to the prison grounds, where he was fatally shot by someone in the car. This was a case of mistaken identity. The only part of the video that's rumor is going to be this part. Allegedly YBC members were out that night looking for Sid. He was also on State Road at the same time as Rodney Hargrove and YBC got bogus intel that Sid would be released that night. When they got to CFCF they saw who they thought was Sid and hopped out. What's even crazier is that Amin Hurst, of another gang in West Philly, was arrested and charged for this murder, which we don't believe he committed. The Rodney Hargrove incident is the only incident we are going to speak on that we couldn't confirm 100% but are confident enough to include it in this video. Back to the facts. On Monday, May 17, 2021, exactly 2 months after the prison murder, a 4-year-old girl was hospitalized in stable condition after being shot in the leg. Around 3:40 p.m. on the 3800 block of Wayalusing Avenue, the girl was playing outside with other children when gunfire erupted nearby. A group of men were being chased by another group of men shooting at them. They ran down Wayalusing Ave when the girl was hit. Police responding to the scene took the girl to the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. This 4-year-old little girl was the younger sister of Sid. Their father, Sam Sessom Sr., was in the car with his wife, the girl's mother, when it was hit by gunfire, smashing the windshield. Sid's older brother Sam Sessoms was a standout basketball player for Penn State, who recently transferred to Coppin State and was able to escape the hood temporarily to attend college. Sid was a member of 39th Street and they called him Big 3-9. He was a problem for YBC, that's why they wanted to kill him so bad. They tried and tried, even allegedly killing the wrong person, Rodney Hargrove. They shot Sid's sister, chasing after him. His family would move following the shooting of his sister. They moved to Port Richmond. But as you'll find out more and more in this story, it doesn't really matter where you are in the city when you're in the middle of a war. 4 months after the shooting of the 6-year-old, YBC would again come for Sid. This time, he was on house arrest and a sitting duck. Curry A.K.A. Most Wanted, and another individual would pull up around 8:15 p.m. on September 16th, on the 2900 block of Weigel Street. The front door was open, leaving only a screen door to stop what was about to come. Police say two shooters walked up onto the porch and fired at least 8 shots into the home, hitting Sid and his father Sam Sr. Sid later died at the hospital.
Bruh. Why the fuck would y'all move? Where y'all move to? He said, Port? Some shit like that? Bruh, if I'm gonna move after some tragic shooting, bro, I'm going to go states away. Pack up all the shit and get in the fuck. I can't say that. Man, yeah, I'm going states away. And then I'm beating the shit out of my son. Like, bro, what the fuck you got going on? Like, you dangering your little sister? You dangering us? Like,
minutes after the gunfire rang out, police responded and a witness was able to alert police to an area where the shooters fled. Soon after, officers found Curry running. That's when he started to shoot at officers, according to investigators. He was later found hiding under a car and arrested. As you know by now, the dissing started almost immediately and has become standard with YBC in almost every song. YBC is known to give some of their dead ops different nicknames than the ones their homies called them. They would call Kwani, Q Rizzy, and they would call Sid, Fro.
Who do it better? Mix it fro with that Q Rizzy, get it wet. Mosky in the back screen, Fro. Three was at the light main bow. Rizzy in the pack, key blow. I just put a switch on my phone. If Rizzy never crossed the street, they probably never tapped his head.
They told me don't diss the dead. I'm like, I can't stop. Fro buddy snipe all in the air. That's 3 different blocks.
Rizzy, don't no more
nigga, we spin froze.
We spinning back to back, then back to back.
Sliding
back
up like back. Shit blow.
Spin once, then spin again, and spin again.
She couldn't come outside, so we're gonna bring this shit to where he sleep. He need a what? He need a GoFund. All that trolling on the Grammy should have had his gun.
YBC and Lamont / 39th Street are continuing the back and forth, and as with all beef, there's no end in sight.
We bent that block for Q-Row.
Please XFI.
Why he running in them jails?
Why please X do?
Why he ain't pay a man bail?
We thinking he a demon.
Bullets put him through hell.
Or die for no reason.
Mission can't be found.
Looking on
he mixed well with the gelato.
Like a fool fight, the way these niggas duck they tie.
In the jails, he's so innocent. He was dissing on the bros, you don't remember it. You know what I'm on, I'm just trying to spin that shit. If I see him spinning on the mind, then I'ma flip the whip. And couldn't find niggas, they say we ain't been. They know what's up, I don't got reminders.
I'm putting time in the plot and I'm trying to kill.
You know I ain't a thief, but my hands are the stuff.
If I see a op, you know I'm aiming where his head is.
On the mind, it's so high, I'll be like, where the feds at?
He text me, said I'm not on my block, I just read that.
I don't smoke shh,
that's like exit with a red jack.
Shout out my dog, Big 39, stand doing business.
This in Q Raw, he making the bad decision.
If he said them one smoke in that prison.
Playing with them bangers, a little different from the blinking.
He was dissing on my mans in the jail, story different.
Officers transported the victim to the hospital, but unfortunately the victim did not survive his injuries. All right, and what's going to be coming up on your screen is the video of the second incident that occurred just 30 minutes later in North Philadelphia, a number of miles away. And in this video, there's our suspect vehicle. The suspects are going to be jumping out of the car, and you're going to see momentarily they're going to start firing shots at our victim. This is in the 25.
It's going to do a. I ain't see part two up here, but we got part three.
Talking about, bro would have gave me a 100 bands would be handy. Yeah.
It's okay.
Go ahead,
let it out. It's okay.
All y'all out here know I said fuck about y'all. All y'all that say that told since he was alive, how much y'all had his back, his family back. I swear y'all just better stand on that, bro. Because y'all can ask anybody standing to the right or left of y'all. Sid had y'all back the most out of anybody in the world. If y'all can't do it, just do it for me. Y'all know what's up with me, man. Like, say it was the most loyal kid ever. Like, ever. We all wishing we could have fucking been in the crib with him.
In the first two parts of this series, we looked at YBC and the ongoing war they are involved in and around West Philly. In part one, we went over the beef with the 9th or 39th in Aspen and Lamont, and the killing of Sid and Q Raw.
That shit probably got took down. That shit probably got took down off some, That shit probably got took down because, it said arrest. Let me see. Yeah, when I looked up there, it wasn't up there. It still ain't up there. Fuck it. I'm gonna go to part three now.
We also spoke about their beef with 56th Street / the Clappers. Over the death of Snipe and K3. That beef started over the said killing of K3 and Snipe, and how an 0-4 member was the target. Right there, that's four different sets YBC is into it with. That isn't even half the sets they currently have beef with. From watching the first two videos, you would think that YBC is up big time. As we said at the end of the last video, when it comes to the streets, if you're laughing now, you're more than likely going to be crying later. 2021 was a year of YBC picking off members and associates of their ops. They celebrated and dissed and made it look like they were having the time of their lives. Then the arrests started to come at the end of 2021 and the beginning of 2022. Reek, F5, Curry, Baby1K, Baby Wick, Zombie, and others are currently booked and facing murder charges.
The mic can talk that shit cause we been laughing from the start. I ain't gon' lie by my rap, go extra streets. I made him off for a couple bands. That boy keep capping in his rap. He ain't get back for his little man. That little dish your homie too, that shit ain't none cause he a capper. Bitch, it's Christmas time, I tell my shooters, gift wrap me a clapper. My shooter's hungry, but I told he bring his head back on the platter.
Don't get it twisted, bitch. Yeah, I still pop right out that cut. He out of luck. Caught his ass up on that side. He should've ducked. We spin back to back. Bodies in one day. They know what's up. We get it done. Get that drop and drop his ass. This shit for fun. Let's add up dead niggas. Throw and see it coming. Oh, let's not.
Put his ass up on that side. He should've ducked. We spin back to back. Bodies in one day. They know what's up. We get it done. Get that drop.
You know who I am. Y'all see what's going on.
Big YFA. Big YFA right here.
DK.
1200.
Baby with like 5 feet, but he bang like Shaquille. Hit a nigga with the switch and make you shake like Jabril.
We been chasing shit down, we at front. It's like train at the train. Them niggas know that we ain't done. Somebody please ask them out, like why they running with their gun? I heard they hiding on the roof, tell them come down. They niggas keep talking about. How the fuck Tom let the switchy off twice in one day? How the fuck he let the switchy go up twice in one day? Niggas know we cranked up, we crank your niggas' head. Me ain't lucky here alive, the Lord niggas should be dead. Please don't disrespect us, cause we got the city scared. Bro said he gon' pay the whole.
Those were some of the heavy steppers for YBC. They still have active members on the streets, but the ones we just mentioned were willing to crash out and rot in prison for the guys. 2022 started out as usual for YBC. Dissing dead ops and making music videos, building a buzz for the people that like drill music. The narrative for passive onlookers was that YBC is cooking the competition. Between January and April, YBC would release 6 videos on YBC Duel's YouTube channel. 1 on F5's and 1 on Eamstack's YouTube. YBC would get off in these videos talking about the victims of their opponents. Names like Q5, K3, Buddy, Young Bull from the Back Block, Rel, Benji, Fro, and Snipe, among others, are all names you might have heard.
Bro felt that hot shit, he start breakdancing. Had he tried to do a GY and bust a train. Wanna know the best strain, bro, the best pay. Looking on a vid and one mirror ran
trick. One be on the gram trolling like my bro ain't hit him up. Said we making up these names, y'all about to make me dig them up. Your homie heard them shots, he ain't you back, he just took off. But just was typing on the net, no hand trying ball.
3 pounds of the fro, I sell it whole and break it down. February 24th, we smoke Q-Rizzy out the pound. He caught a headshot on the 9, they felt that little boy out of bounds. I got the whole fucking city smoking Buddy out the pound.
And when I saw that nigga die, he was thinking with his dick. Mixed the fro with that Buddy and I bet that I won't hit. I put on my murder suit and then I'm trying to pay you. I be trying to bend that back and do that bitch right.
I miss the fro with the snipe, that shit make my lungs hurt. Well, I don't smoke Q-Rizzy no more, that nigga dirt. And I'm smoking Buddy out the fucking pound every verse. And it's switchies on it good, when they shoot, I bet it turns.
Try mix up Kike with that Buddy, feel like that's the best trend.
We get active, nigga know what's up. He did all that trolling, should've ducked. Heard he left his little ass stuck. Catch him cracking threes and they get touched. Bro got a Glock with a beam and a switch, you just tap. Yeah, his little ass done got whack. They took our homies, we got a whole lot of strange. Just tell me who you want to match.
Nobody on the 9, so we gon' bend a mind. They ain't get back, they still taking pictures on that rooftop. Q-Rizzy died so fast, the nigga
These are real people lost to this war, and a lot of people are hurt behind that.
You went up last time, you was on your block, Libby.
What happened?
Went up last time, you was on your block.
Who said that?
Nigga, that's down there. The nigga on the last time he was on your block.
Well, all he on my
shit got
right
cracking, and DK died the next day.
Khalid Lizzieur was found shot inside of a blue 2020 Honda Accord on Friday, May 13, 2022. At 8:17 p.m., Philadelphia police officers responded to the 1200 block of South 57th Street and found Khalid in the driver's seat of the vehicle. He had been shot numerous times.
That's crazy, bruh. This is crazy as shit, bro. Just to see the bullet holes all through the car. Bruh, if we can dedicate, as us as black people can dedicate this time and energy into something like productive, bro, we could realize be millionaires, bruh. Like, real shit. Like, niggas can be real-life millionaires. Niggas could change their whole family structure, like, on some like real Black Wall Street shit, like back in the day, like real, like have like a Black Wall Street set up, like, bruh. I don't think y'all understand that. Like, if y'all dedicate some time and effort and energy into doing some shit, like some real stand up shit, bruh, niggas will go far.
Per personnel arrived and pronounced Khalid deceased at the scene. Khalid Lizayur, Baby Ka, or BK, was 19-year-old at the time of his death. He lived on South 57th Street.
BK, get BK in the camera too.
Well, we now have breaking news on what police are calling an execution-style shooting in the King's Sessing neighborhood that left a 19-year-old male dead. Officials arrived on the 1200 block of South 57th Street just after 8 this evening and found the victim shot multiple times in his car. Officials say at least 29 shell casings were found. We're also told two males in dark clothing approached the vehicle on foot and started firing.
To anyone paying attention, the news wasn't a big shock that a YBC member was killed. It was only a matter of time. The clappers are claiming this wreck and BK was dissed heavily after his death.
My homie died and they dismissed, that's why BK had no luck.
A 19-year-old man shot multiple times inside his car. Claim we ain't get back for bro like shit. Check out cousin. I'm gonna keep popping my shit, y'all rap like they left him dead as fuck.
They want no end. What? This is the nigga that signed the Polo G, right? Young Lav. I didn't know he was beefing with them.
19-year-old man shot multiple times inside his car.
Claim we ain't get back for bro like shit. Check out cousin. I'm gonna keep popping my shit, y'all rap like they left him dead as fuck. But they wasn't no innocent. The law just say that cause he died too young. He got dropped now, check the stats, bitch. We ain't eat. Why you let Philly scoreboard gas you like them clappers? Ain't the reason. Smoke on Snipe, they got his low. Now check the stats, they rap a piss. I didn't have to get no car. I knew it first around like 9 p.m.
Nigga had just looked bro when they ran down. He felt two different gems.
24 plus 6, up the beam. Quill on tie, don't hear the same no more. It's WK for me. When black and me, that Honda cut start up. Now we smoke BK out the fucking pink. This why I pass a message. Say they caught cocky, been quiet.
On June 17th, YBC was celebrating the birthday of BK when news came that another member had lost their life. YBC Kier allegedly got in an argument with his friend on the night of June 17th and a fight ensued. What happened after that we can't say for certain, as the news around this has been very quiet. No YBC members are talking about it and no ops are claiming this. He would, like everyone else, be dissed heavily after his death.
Wonder why I care to have a gun on them. 2022, you see, you can't punch on them. He lost that fight because a bullet has gone.
YBC would be looking for blood and they would head to a familiar place. This poppy store is seen as a representation of 39th Street and the Mont, and their most known rapper, Tat. He can be seen shooting a music video here, and when YBC spins, they usually check here first. One day after Kier died, YBC would be trying to walk down on this very location. Three men dressed in all black would come down 39th Street. When they hit Poplar, a huge security spotlight was on and gave away any element of surprise the three might have had. Because as soon as they hit the alleyway, shots would come from the direction they were headed. One of the three men dropped. It looks like a few shots might have been returned, but the remaining two were obviously shook and ran off, before doubling back for a couple of seconds to try and get their fallen friend, but it was pointless. He couldn't get up. Eamstead.
Did I just hear they was going to get their friend and they said
Max was one of the three men on that drill, and word soon got out about the situation. Rumors spread that he had died, but in the next few days, the truth would come out. Eam and two others were headed to slide on the 9 when they were caught off guard. Eam Stacks is seemingly paralyzed and is currently in jail on gun charges.
Been that block for Q-Roll. Last time they been through the 9, they made out 8 flag. Last time they been through the mines, my nigga shot bang. Took a pick on the 3rd, we got there like where they at. Parents, let me try to get away from the law. And these fans better than they murder suit. Made us dumbass collect. When they pull up on, I'ma be the one buying the rest. Fans better than they murder suit. Made us dumbass collect. When they pull up on, I'ma be the one buying the rest. When they try to
Rapper slid and got fucked up. He must come hold the Draco up.
Nigga, she take his chain and test his image. They hit up with so much shots. He hitting like two different niggas. They ran infested. YBC young bunch of chatting ass.
Not even a week later, YBC's string of horrible luck would continue when Domeen Grant or Da Fetty was murdered on Saturday, June 25, 2022. At 12:52 p.m., Philadelphia police officers responded to the 500 block of West Bristol Street and found Domeen suffering from several gunshot wounds to his body. Police placed him in their patrol vehicle and transported him to Temple University Hospital, where he was pronounced deceased at 1:02 p.m. Da Fetty was 20 years old and he lived on Parkside Avenue. The Mont and Westside Mafia from Uptown are claiming this. This story goes to show you that there are no winners and losers in street wars. Just generations of young men and fathers are lost to the cycle. YBC and 56th Street, the Mont and 02 to 4th and 39th Street are just a few blocks that are warring. The violence continues daily and there is no end in sight.
Yeah, that shit don't make no sense because, like, bro just said, like, bro, it's just losses. Like, bro, shit don't matter at the end of the day. Like, after a while, you know, niggas not even gonna check up on your family no more. Like, you got out of, like, 20 niggas, you got probably, like, two that still gonna, like, after 5-10 years, you got two motherfuckers that still gonna be thinking about you. Like, oh man, still reach out to your mother, still come to a function, still, you know, do fly shit like that. Like you still here type shit. Niggas still gonna do that. Cause those are real friends, but for real, niggas be a thing of the past. And that shit, y'all, like, be wicked, cause you think, when you, everybody here, when everybody in the circle, everybody in alignment, you think it's ride or die, but it don't even be that. Like, the shit be so fucked up, like, it really be out of sight, out of mind, that you got niggas that's in jail, right? You got niggas that's in jail. And nigga ain't putting no money on your books. You hear shit all the time. Your nigga ain't look out for me, nigga ain't put no money on my books. Nigga ain't reach out to my mother. Nigga ain't ask my mother if I need anything, nigga ain't woo woo, like, it just be on some, like, free him or rip him. But it's like, when it come down to doing, like, real stand up man shit, nigga don't even be standing on that type of business. Like, you, it's really, you forgot about, out of sight, out of mind. But y'all niggas is all talented, like, both sides, like, y'all niggas is all talented. Like, bro, I know y'all can't come together, but, and like I said, bro, y'all don't even have to, like, man, make as much money as possible, bro. Y'all in the music business. Like, I don't think y'all understand. Like, y'all rapping, y'all in the music business. Make some money to change your family's lives. Like, your families, everybody that's around. If it's 30 niggas around, all y'all should have money to change y'all family life. Get off them blocks. Who the fuck wanna die on a street that you won't own? I'm sure that y'all don't own them houses. Like, who wanna die doing that shit? Like, it's no honor in that. That's not honorable. We fighting over blocks we never own. We fighting over a house that we don't own. It's no honor in that. I mean, y'all, like I said, y'all niggas got so much talent that y'all could change the world. So I'm just trying to get y'all to see that shit. Like, even if y'all ops is like this, y'all, do it in a different way. Hey, I just made 30,000 this year off streams. Not even this year, but this month off streams. How much you, how you taunt your ops? You taunt your ops that way, like, oh man, how much you make this month? Oh, you made a 10? Well, I made 30. Try again next month. Like, change it up a little bit. Like, speak about the money. Like, hey, we got more money than y'all of music. Like, we made 50 off music this month. How much you make? 25? Man, try again next month. Like, you know what I mean? Like, do some fly shit. Like, but that's my thought about this, man. I'm gonna see how people's in the next video. Peace.